Hey there, welcome back to the workshop. Today we're going to be taking a look at Revell's brand new for 2017 Halo UNSC Pelican. This is about 1/100th scale. It's for ages 8 and up because it is a snap together kit, but anyone can build it, just as you saw with the Warthog kit I built. It is a light and sounds and includes two pilots. Let's take a look at everything that's in the box. Got the standard manual here. It is a 16-step manual. Guides you through all the steps quite easily, including decaling and how to change the batteries in 16 easy peasy steps. Up next will be the decal sheet. You can take a look there. These are vinyl pressure sensitive decals. These are not water slides. Registry is good and they look wonderful. Next up, we'll start looking at some of the plastic. There's a good amount of plastic in here and there are no plastic trees. So we'll start pulling stuff apart and letting you look at it. Now here we can see you get two of these. Nice mold lines, great detail on all these parts, and as you can see, no flash, and they are pre-colored. We have two of these here, more cool panel lines. These all go into assembling the extra big jet. This is a light and sound module. It's also the cockpit. You can see the button right there and the speaker on the bottom. We can activate that and let you see the lights and hear the sounds. That looks pretty cool. So that's going to be awesome inside the kit. A little bit of pre-lighting and sound effects for you. Normally you got to do that yourself and it adds to the model. Here's some interior shots from these parts. You can see some benches back there. And you can get an idea of the scale of the kit. Those would be for the troops, of course. Master Chief, Kelly, Frederick, and others. Take a look at that. Those are twin parts. We've got the access, what I think is the access hatch right here. It does have wings that will rotate and a hatch that will open in the back, increasing playability for those of you that want to buy this as a gift for your kids. Or, let's be serious, I still fly model ships around when I build them too. Let's not pretend we don't. More random panels and accessory parts. Nice panel lines on there. You get two of those. We've got some other small parts like tail fins, I'm assuming, because I can see the elevator or aileron tabs on there. We've got some more gray molded parts. Get a good look at that. Inside, more awesome panel lines. Now, I will be weathering this and doing a full build on this review, so you'll get to see this all go together. You know you're going to want one. So just go and order one while we're talking, and then you'll be able to come back and build along with me. We got two wing sections. They are right there. They're mirror images of each other, so I just only need to show you one. But great lines on there. I like the deep panel lines. They'll absorb that wash and weathering and really stand out nicely. Then we've got two more hull and intake parts here. You can see that nice design on there. Looks great. We've got a bag of smaller parts here that I will only be taking out when it's assemble time. And what do I not want to miss? I don't want to miss the cockpit glass. That looks really nice. It is not foggy. That's just my warm fingers. It is actually very clear. And they've done all the masking for you. Because, masking cockpits can be so difficult. You're going to get two parts like this for intakes. That nice honeycomb pattern. And you'll get mirror image on these intakes as well. Mirror image parts will give the camera a second to catch up. It takes a little bit to focus on that honeycomb. And those will go together like that with panel lines. One last thing I wanted to show you before I start working on it. You will get two pilot figures. They are right there inside the box. One is green, one is gray with some other nozzle detail inside there. And other various small parts that are clear with a frosted paint on them. So we're going to see where all those go in a little bit. I'm going to start building the kit, and we will come back in just a minute to see how we're going on the UNSC Pelican from Revell for Halo. I did it to you again. You thought I was all done. You didn't notice that I missed the fuselage. I didn't miss it. I'm just messing with you guys. Huge. Look at the size of that thing. That is a nice big jet. Lots of styrene plastic in this one. We got the grill there on the bottom for the speaker. And you can see the nice panel line details. wing attachment points and extra large snap attachment points, which won't break easily on you. You can see the upper fuselage. Great parts in there. Nice panel lines where the cockpit goes in. We'll be assembling all of it. I'll be right back. As I start to snap things together, what I'm going to do is assemble the kit, then weather it. This one I don't have to do it in pieces. This one I can do it all once it's assembled. We'll be right back. Pelican is all assembled. Thanks for following along with that slideshow. This one I decided to put all together in one run because then I can weather it and detail it as one ship. I even put the decals on, put the cockpit on. Now before I start detailing, I'll be taking that cockpit off just so I don't cloud up the glass. But it does have a high amount of playability. If you do want to play with it, you can even pull out the bottom and look inside, put some figures in there, snap it up. We've got landing gear. You can put them up, and in the bottom, you can have it like so. Let me take that off. I just attached it loosely because I do want to make sure I take it off. The wings and the rear engines are completely rotatable, and they do index. So you can mount them in any location you so desire as you're flying it around the room, having fun. Those will rotate. These ones will actually rotate completely 360. And then, like I said, you've got the landing gear on the bottom, the cargo door, the rear landing gear arms that come down and go up in different indexed areas. So you've got a lot of playability with that. If you do want to play with it, I'm going to detail it because all my stuff is more of a shelf queen, and I just wanted the cool Halo ship. So I'm going to come back. We're going to start doing some of the same weathering techniques that we did on the Warthog. You can take a look at that video for exact specifics. When I come back, I'll be working on some cool weathering and detailing of Revell's Halo Pelican ship. I'll be right back. What I'm working on now is the weathering part of the kit. And as you can see, I've done the bottom of the hull and brought out the panel lines nicely in the low-lying areas and highlighted the high areas by wiping it off gently. So you can see those panel lines really stick out. On the top, you can definitely see the difference between the two. This area here has not been touched at all. This area here has been washed to bring out those panel lines much darker, like there's dirt and grime. Now, to continue that, and I showed you that on the Warthog video, but jets also have different wear patterns and weather patterns, such as around the back of the engines here, where you're going to have exhaust coming out, hot exhaust. It's going to discolor all the paint, and it's going to darken it up. So what you can do is continue to apply your wash to those areas until you reach the darkness level that you desire. You see how the much darker this one's getting than this side, because I've been working on this side. And then you can continue applying your wash in the exact same way I showed you in that Warthog video, and applying it around the very back, all around the back of the engine. And you'll just keep applying it and getting it to the dark tone that you desire. And then you'll hit that with your heat gun, and you'll let that dry completely. And with the heat gun, it doesn't take long. But once that dries, then you'll get a really nice darker tone, and you can come and apply another coat anytime you want. The panel line wash is the exact same black paint, mixed up at least 50 to 50, and we just paint it on the entire area. And of course, I'm working on the tail here, so it's easy for you to see. And if you need a little more, it's fine. You can't really use too much of it. Now you see that it's starting to soak into those panel lines. You can already see them. The panel lines are getting darker than the exterior areas of the panels. Now I love to use old socks because they're very smooth on the outside. Don't use the inside. And you can just kind of gently wipe the upper areas. Now you're going to take some out of the low-lying areas, but it's going to start sticking in there. And then what you'll do is you're going to hit it with the heat gun. So excuse the noise of the heat gun here. You're going to start drying it off in those panel lines that are the lowest at the moment. Now don't put too much heat on there or you're going to melt the plastic. You know, don't hold it over there or you'll end up with a big warped mess. And then you're going to have to do a pelican that got shot down diorama. But then you can just go back to your wash, get a little more on the brush. And now that the plastic has a little bit of that acrylic in it already, now you can really see it grab on to that wash, to that weathering, okay? And that's pretty much all the wash is. And now you let it sit for a little bit, and then you just kind of start wiping it off again with a little bit of a lighter finger, not as much pressure. And it's a learned behavior, so you're going to wipe a lot of it off the first time you try. And the next time you try, you're going to wipe less, and you're going to figure it out for yourself. But you hit it with the heat gun again. And you can see that as it dries, it really starts to take on that darker panel line texture. They also make specific panel line washes you can buy. I prefer to just make it myself. It works a lot easier. Now I'm going to continue doing that to the rest of the kit here. You can see how the back is completely different looking than the front. I'm going to continue working on the top side of the model till I'm done. Then we'll be back for a final. See you soon. Welcome back for the final on Revell's awesome Halo UNSC Pelican. We're all done. All the weathering has been done. I just continued the techniques that I showed you in the previous clip and kept working. You can see that I washed and I just continued to wash the intakes to darken those up quite a bit. I left the front of the cockpit a little less weathered. And I left the cockpit glass pretty much clean, just gave it a quick wipe and a dry off, because the front of the aircraft will always stay a lot cleaner than the rest. Then you can see where I continued to darken and darken and darken with the black, simulating grease and burn marks on the engine exhaust. You can see on the back here where it's very dark, and it's also dirtier towards the back of the ship, and it's dirtier with the burn marks outside of all the different various engine exhausts. The kit assembled easily. You can see there's no big nasty looking seams. It looks really nice. There's no problems with assembly. Everything snaps together exactly the way they should go together. And the electronics, of course, are pretty cool. It lights up the cockpit. And it looks really awesome. And these side marker lights also light up when it's a little darker. They're an orange color like I showed you in the first part. So I like this, and this is easily how you can take a snap-tight model and make it look weathered and beat up with a really simple wash, a really simple wear on it, and it's going to look like a completely different model. What I also like about the washing with the acrylics is that it will flatten the plastic. The plastic is a little glossy because of the mold process. When you use the acrylics on it, a flat acrylic with a little bit of Windex in it, it actually really flattens that out, gives it a lighter green, a more drab green look to it, and it actually looks quite nice. Now, you saw in the other video, I built the Warthog. Those are the two new models from Revell in the Halo series. They're both wonderful. I like that they're a little bit different shades of green, so they don't blend in with each other. We've got one 32nd scale, one 100th scale. They're awesome. They both build easy, and with just a little bit of light weathering, they both turn out really nice. Thanks for watching the workshop. I'll see you at the next review.